Welcome to my first excavation session. It's really astonishing that I'm already 18 years in the scene of classic Citroëns. So, in search of something to put on that wall, I went in the attic and found some boxes and stuff like this from a meeting we made in 2010, and something happens to the camera, strange. And we did also postcards with the route where to go. Anyway, I have still stuff left from that. I think I should try to sell it on behalf of the Amical Swiss, who paid for the stuff. So what else did I see? This was 50 years DS, like organized by French, and from that endeavor is also this this issue of the joint magazine of Swiss and German DS Club from 2005, and on the cover it's a friend of mine from the club who I think in the meantime has sold his break. Anyway, as you see, the Germans are serious about their tire tests for new makes for the DS, and it looks really interesting. So what else did I find? I found something I probably bought because once in my life I had the CX, so this is very important, but well, CX went away in the meantime. So what else? That was probably at the Rome meeting or in 2008, where I found this Italian booklet about Bertoni. And I was really astonished that sometimes I buy books and they don't even unbox or unwrap them. So I can do some unwrap video about it. And there is another issue of our joint publication. This has even an outing of the Swiss DS Club described with text and pictures. Aha! And also found, oops, this brochure about the Citroën Mobile in Holland. It's always very interesting because it's huge. There are so many Citroëns, almost the parking lot is much more interesting than the exhibitions and the market. So what else we have? For the 50 years of DS, our club made something for the members, and I even didn't bother to make it right. It's a stand for napkins, and so you should put this like right angle and then you could put napkins. But I'm the guy to preserve stuff in its original state, so I left it. Another thing is, what 2006, a colleague of mine and myself, we were at the Merano Classic Citroën meeting. There was an official brochure stuff with roots and everything. And these meetings are really always very, very nice because we get to see some from the landscape of South Tyrol. We get some routes to drive in a certain time, not quick, but yeah, you know how this is, the rallies. And that was really interesting. What else we had? 2012, we got invited, some of us, to go to the 30-year anniversary of the SM Club, and we went to Paris. There was a guy who bought the most expensive DS cabriolet ever. I think he paid 280,000 euros for it because there was a German who was also bidding and he didn't want to allow the German to get the car. And he had also a very astonishing collection to show us. He asked even some friends to drive up and show off the machines. So this is just outside of Paris, and I have to look up how it, what's his name, but he's very known, very well known in the scene. So that's it for all. Sometimes you get models, you also forget. It's really interesting. It's a DS Gendarmerie. And even little, what is it, jumper. But I don't know whether this was given by Citroën, because it has the Citroën sticker on it. And yeah, so that was the result. Oh no, something else, if I can find it. Hello again, I found it. It's a very mysterious envelope, perhaps you can read. And I was really, didn't know at all what it was about. So I was very astonished when I saw this. Or perhaps not upside down. It's like the microfiche for spare parts for CX. So I later try to scan them. But we'll see what it will give. So that's all for now. If you'd like to see more videos about the DS or other cars or my excavation endeavors, please subscribe. And I'll see you in another video. Goodbye. Autoglym? Where did that come from? Funky.